In this video, I'll be using an example to explain the difference between the task types fixed duration, fixed units, and fixed work when effort-driven is selected or not selected. Now, your fixed duration, fixed units, and fixed work are task types that is used in scheduling software like Microsoft Project, Project Libre, and other software. It is used to calculate the amount of time, the resource units, and work required to complete a task. And the formula that's used in the software is work equals duration times resource units. And a task type is assigned to each task. So each task in your project schedule, a specific task type need to be assigned. Like in this example, we've got your task information. The task type can be selected, either fixed duration, fixed unit, or fixed work. And your effort driven is either selected, ticked, or not selected, unticked. Now your effort driven, that's your work, and it's selected or not selected for each task. And when effort driven is selected, it means that the work required to complete a task is fixed. So your work is going to remain fixed regardless of how many resources are assigned to a task. Now duration, that is the amount of time required to complete a task, and it can be hours, days, or weeks. So we've got our task, and our duration is 5 working days. Units, that's the number of resources assigned to a task. It can be people, equipment, or material. For this example, we'll work with resources, with people. We've got 2 people assigned to a task, each working 8 hours per day. And now the work is the amount of effort required to complete a task. That is work equals duration times your resource units. So the work for this specific task is resource 1, working 5 days at 8 hours per day. It's 40 hours plus resource 2, 5 days times 8 hours is a total of 80 hours for the 5 working days duration. Now let's have a look at our first example where we've got fixed duration and effort driven is on. So effort driven is selected, meaning that our work is fixed and our duration is fixed. Fixed duration, effort driven on. In this example, we've got task A, B, C, and D, with task A and C on our critical path, and 1 resource allocated to each task. So we've set up our schedule and we baseline the schedule. So for task C, the duration is 6 days, so it's 6 working days. We've got 1 resource allocated to the task with a rate of $40 per hour. Our work is 6 working days times 1 resource working 8 hours per day. So our work for task C is 48 hours. And then our cost for task C is 48 hours times $40 per hour. It's a total of $1,920. So baseline cost, $1,920. So now, after we've baselined our schedule, what happens if we assign an additional resource to task C? So now we assign an additional resource at a rate of $70 per hour to task C. So what happens? Our duration is fixed and our work is fixed. So our work remained 48 hours. So each resource now works 24 hours and the work still remains 48 hours. Resource 1 is 40 times 24, it's $960, and resource 2 is $70 per hour times 24 hours, it's $1,680, total of $2,640 is our cost after we've added an additional resource. Now, if effort-driven is off, important only our duration is fixed, and the work can change and the resource unit can change. So if we add an additional resource, what happens is our work increase. So resource 1 is going to work 48 hours, as well as resource 2 will work 48 hours. So both of the resources will now work 48 hours, and our work will increase to 96 hours. So our duration remains the same, 6 days. Work is now 96 hours, and the total cost will now increase to $5,280. It's $5,280. Resource 1, 40 times 48 is 1,920, and resource 2, 70 times 48 hours, $3,360. So in summary, if we have fixed duration, effort-driven on, meaning our work is going to be fixed and our duration is fixed, the two resources will now work 24 hours each at a total cost of $2,640. If you've got fixed duration, effort-driven off, meaning our work can change, we add an additional resource and each resource will now work 48 hours, total of 96 hours, and our cost increases to $5,280. So in our second example, let's look at fixed units, effort-driven on, using the same example as we've used in fixed duration. So effort-driven on, our work is fixed. Fixed units, our resource remains fixed. Now, if we add an additional resource to task C, what happens now? Our duration is going to change. So if we add an additional resource, we're going to complete our task quicker, and we will complete our task in 3 working days, meaning that resource 1 will work 24 hours. That's 3 days times 8 hours, and resource 2 will work 24 hours at a total of 48 hours. So our work remains 48 hours, and we've got now 2 resources each working 24 hours. 24 times $40 per hour is $960, and 24 times $70 per hour is $1,680, and a total cost of $2,640. That is our total cost with fixed units and effort-driven on. Work is fixed and our resources is fixed and our duration has now changed. We've added an additional resource and we complete our task now in 3 working days and not 6 working days. So when effort-driven is switched off, only our resources are fixed. And now we add an additional resource. So our work will change. Resource 1 will now remain working 48 hours, and resource 2 will work 48 hours, a total of 96 hours. And our cost increases to $5,280. 40 times 48 is 1,920. And 70 times 48 is $3,360. So in summary, we've got fixed units, effort-driven on, so our work remains 48 hours. We've added an additional resource. Our duration decreases to 3 working days, each resource working 24 hours at a cost of $2,640. And if effort-driven is switched off, our work will increase to 96 hours, each resource working 48 hours, at a total cost of $5,280. And then lastly, our fixed work. So if we select fixed work as a task type, the effort-driven is selected, by default, so you can only have effort driven on with fixed work. So our work is fixed. Our work remains 48 hours, so each resource will be able to work 24 hours, and our duration decreases to 3 working days. So it's 3 days times 8 hours per day per resource. So for 24 hours times $40, it's $960. 70 times 24 is $1,680, total of $2,640. So if we've got fixed work, effort driven on, our duration decreases to 3 working days because our work is fixed at 48 hours. So in summary, we've got fixed work, effort driven is on, so the option is always ticked. Our work remains 48 hours. If we add an additional resource, the duration decreases to 3 working days at a cost of $2,640. I hope this video provided you with a better understanding of fixed duration, fixed units, and fixed work when effort-driven is selected and not selected. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, or you can subscribe to my channel for more project management related videos.